Hello guys, Golden Tails Geek here. Welcome back to Playing Video Games for the First Time, my series of first impressions videos. This week's episode, the final episode of this month of point and click adventure games, The Silent Age. You can get this on Steam. I think it's also on iOS and Android as well, but in an episodic form. But I bought this game months ago. It was like 90% off. I had to snatch it up. It was just worth it. But yeah, and I'll put a link in the video description so you can get it for yourself. But anyway, from what I understand it, it's involving this kind of janitor guy from like the 70s or something who gets transported to the future, and there's all sorts of other timey-wimey things that happen, and it's just, where basically he's trying to save the future from something, I don't know. But it just really appealed to me, so I figured I'd get it, so. Plus, it was just really wicked cheap, so what the hell. Anyway, let's click to start here. That's cool. It looks like a little chaptered format here. And you can even access the credits right off the bat, too. That's kind of cool, but we're not going to do that. We're going to start in the present. Oh, 1965. Okay, I was wrong. It's not the 70s, it's the 60s. But anyway. '68. I guess we're showing the passage of time a little bit. I'm kind of liking the minimalist style of this game, actually. It's kind of appealing. 1969, year of the moon landing. Also, I think it was the year my parents got married. At least that's what they tell me. Buffet, all you can eat. My, how things change. 1971. Okay. Looks like he's working in a high school or something. '72. Chapter 1, The Present. Okay, fair enough. Mr. Hill wants to see you. Frank, huh? One. Let's go to the supply room here. Light bulb should come in handy. Yeah, let's head over here to this light bulb here. Alright, so let's change the bulb then. Bingo! Here we go. Ow! Bright! Nice. Pick up the card. What's all this stuff? Okay. I think we can turn off the light now. Alright, fair enough. detail of like. Can I close it? No, I guess not. Oh well, at least I got the I got that little blue access card. Let's see here. Let's use it on the card reader here. And permission to enter the bridge, sir. That sounds like something. Apparently, it was a Star Trek reference. I mean, Star Trek was pretty big back then. So. Talk to the secretary. Fair enough. See what Mr. Hill wants then. Jasper, huh? Oh, no, Joe, okay. 2 years, huh? That's about as long as I've been working at my job, so. Frank's assignments. Interesting. I got an achievement called Working for the Man. One nation under God. Honest Richard, huh? Yeah. Yeah, keep telling yourself that. Of course, I still remember that episode of Doctor Who where Richard Nixon showed up. The actor who played him actually thought he did good. Alright, well, might as well head back down to the elevator here. Whoop, okay, fair enough. Let's just. Ooh, red access card reader. Well, that's convenient. Open sesame. Nice. What's this thing? Can you pick it up? Pong. No? Alright, let's see here. Perfect. Okay, let's see what's in here. Oh, wow. There's blood here. I got an achievement. The error. It said, no, don't touch anything. Handkerchief, huh? Well, let's use it on the blood and see if we can,
Far out.
All right, let's see if we can get back to management with this bloody handkerchief. Kind of liking the game so far. Got a nice minimalist style. Not too overwhelming. Well, so much for telling management about this. You know what? Let's go find out what that door's up to. Maybe we can use the Band-Aid. Behind that door is what I mean, but whatever. Sorry, I'm not really fully all there right now. I'm kind of trying to... I'm just kind of excited to be playing this game. Especially after not playing this game... right when I got it, because I was kind of planning on actually recording a video of this game not long after I got it, but unforeseen circumstances got in the way. Anyway, let's just head back over here, I suppose. Oh, hey, hang on. Okay, cool. I can double-click on things real quickly.
Far out.
Let's see if we can use a Band-Aid on one of these buttons here. There we go. Let's use it on the other button. And... Eureka! How about that? Alright, let's go through the door here. Oh, wow! Hello, sir! Got shot, huh? This version of me isn't this. Oh, wow. Wow. It's a goddamn time machine, okay? It's actually pretty funny. Okay, he's dead. That's not good. That's not good. Chapter 2, The Future. Whoa. Okay, let's see what's going on here. Whoa, okay. Whoa, what the hell? J. Edgar Hoover. Must be the head of the FBI or something. Yeah, let's head up here then. Oh my. I don't know who that fella is, but I feel bad. Fail for him. See if we can use this key on the door here. Nope, doesn't fit. Okay, let's head up to the second floor then. A picture of Abraham Lincoln.
Far out.
A safe hidden, I wonder. No, okay. Wonder if I can use the key in this door. Bingo! The corpse lying here. Oh, jeez. Use the hammer on the padlock. Let's check back in here real quick, see if I missed anything. No, I guess not. I'm actually kind of surprised that I've made such good progress in a short space of time here. But we'll see. Is there any other locked doors I could use this with? Let's see. There we go. That worked. Let's check the desk here. I'll take that oil too, that might come in handy. Gotta love carp. Nice. Supposed to do now. Let's head back in here real quick. Can I combine? No, I guess not. Okay. Guess we'll head back to the Evans thing and see what we can get here. Ah, okay. There we go. Let's try that.
Wow.
What's this thing? A katana. I always wanted these, but somehow I feel less excited about it now. Well, let's head back up here and see if maybe we can use the katana to cut that body down. Alright.
Hi-ya!
Nice. Gordian knot, apparently. Guess we better head back down and see if we can inspect the corpse again. Where'd the corpse go? Huh. Okay, let's head to the ground floor then. Maybe the body fell down. There it is! The rope to this with the stairs to the basement here, maybe. Anything else in the evidence room I could use, maybe? Doesn't look like it. Of course, why would a katana be in the evidence room is the million-dollar question here, but then again, point-and-click adventure games always seem to have those kind of extraneous things like that, that where you can't really find a good enough justification for things. Yeah, I'm with you on that. Finding boxed evidence. Wow, unregistered sexual aids. That's disconcerting. Anyway, I think I'm gonna call it for today. This game's pretty interesting. I'm very intrigued by it. So yeah, this has been the Silent Age, and I'm actually kind of amazed I'm doing as well as I am on my first go of it, but then again, I've always had a bit of a knack for certain point-and-clickers. Anyway, till my next video, whether it's a Let's Play, a playing video games for the first time video like this, or a video game boss fight video, or any little thing I set up on my channel, keep on gaming, everyone. See you later. Bye!